It's movie time now. Here we are joined in studio by writer, director, Jeremy Saulnier. Jeremy, thanks for joining us. You have a new movie that just premiered this Friday here in Washington, D.C., Green Room, kind of a horror, punk rock thriller, as it were. I up front want to say I apologize. I have not seen the movie yet. I've seen every trailer that I could find online to kind of get up to speed. Tell us a little bit of, you know, this is in some ways average people in a very non-typical circumstance, but it's not your average blood and guts horror film either, is it?
I like to think it's not, but I mean, it's actually a pretty standard cinematic situation, but everyday people thrust into it. So I think it's like, it's fun to have this out-of-town punk rock band all of a sudden find themselves in a brutal siege situation with a bunch of Nazi skinheads at a punk rock show during a live concert. So,
and there you have it.
Yeah. But I definitely gravitate towards stories that are very satisfying, like to genre film lovers, to action junkies, but I put real people in them and it gets real fun.
And so why did you choose to have the setting, the backdrop for this be not just a punk rock venue, but a skinhead punk rock venue?
Well, you know, within the punk rock and hardcore community, ideology aside, they're the most like soldiers. So, I mean, they wear uniforms. They want to be separate. They have their ideology is a bit militant, and so their access to weaponry is more plausible. They're organized. There's a hierarchy there. And so they served in my story as an army.
And are they the villain? Because I know, again, from reading about and watching, you know, there's I don't know, sympathy on both sides, but there's certainly loss on both sides, right?
Yes. Yes, I mean, the point here is you feel the impact of loss. It's a very thrilling experience to go through, but it's also emotional. It's not just a slasher movie. It has a lot more depth to it. And the quote-unquote black hats, the bad guys, you know, there are people too. And so it's really easy to vilify Nazi punk skinheads, you know, but I think the challenge was to humanize them and to show sort of the nature of violence. I mean, not getting too political or too preachy, but there's certainly layers there.
Now, did you worry about blowback from that, from humanizing someone who most of us probably think are not worthy of humanizing?
Well, I think, you know, my approach was to look at some of these young kids who get recruited and who have real problems and real, I guess, issues that they want to deal with, and it's they get into the wrong crowd, and their anger or hatred, whatever it is mischanneled, and I think of them as victims. And as a filmmaker, of course, I mean, stepping out of the political arena, as a filmmaker, that's my job, is to really try and inhabit each role and play it out like I think it would play out, and to sympathize, I think, is a more responsible way to approach this.
I mean, when you say that, it almost reminds me of American History X, in this of kind of stepping back from what we see of this crowd and mm-hmm. kind of taking a look at, well, how do some of these people end up in this crowd? So on the other side is a punk rock band.
Yeah.
So why did you pick that? Why did you pick a punk rock band?
Believe it or not, I mean, you wouldn't know by looking at me now, but about 20 years ago in the Washington, D.C. area, I was sort of into the punk rock hardcore scene and attending lots of shows in the mid-90s. And it really defined my youth. It was such a physical expression. It was a great outlet for everybody. And the music had such like propulsive energy. I wanted to channel that, you know, into a film.
And so let's talk about that. You're a local guy. So where'd you go to high school? Where'd you grow up?
I was born and raised in Alexandria, Virginia. And I went to junior high school, and I went to T.C. Williams High School.
All right, a proud T.C. Williams grad. All right, so
that's right.
What were the clubs that you prowled in your heyday back here?
Well, you know, there's a lot of, like, sort of muni centers or sort of community centers, churches, you know, we played wherever we could. But, you know, the Black Cat, the old 930 Club. We're standard
which just
venues.
Celebrated its like 100th anniversary or something. The 930 Club just I think it was my 30th or 40th anniversary. They had a big World's Fair down there. But so you go back to the F Street location,
yes.
Then, which was truly an epic room. It were rooms. I mean, it just had that feel of a dungeonous cavern.
Yeah.
And so were places like that in your mindset when you were creating a place for this movie?
Textually, of course, yeah. But for this scenario to unfold in a contemporary setting, I had to have it in a secluded sort of area. So the film takes place outside of Portland, Oregon, but I certainly referenced my experience here in D.C.
And well, the band is from D.C., right?
They're from Arlington in the movie, technically, yeah.
But you had the premiere here last night in D.C. Did you want to have it here in your hometown?
Of course. I mean, you know, we've toured with the film, and this is actually our last stop on the big publicity tour. It was great to finally bring it home. We now come to the origin of this story, and it's fun. Some of the characters in the movie are based off my friends, and
I'm sure they appreciate that.
Yeah, some of them survive, some of them don't. You know. On screen, but it was just really fun to finally show them what they inspired.
And I understand your mom saw this film at the premiere. How did that go?
That was tough. I mean, this is the kind of movie that I'm used to. I'm almost 40 now, but I still have the instinct of this is the kind of movie in the 1980s I would be watching on VHS, and when my mom would come in the room, I'd pause it. It's a pretty rough movie, you know. But she's very proud.
So it was not your first movie, so I imagine she kind of knows the path you're going down, right?
Yeah.
So this wasn't a surprise to her.
And, I mean, she's seen me make, I mean, in the backyard in the 1980s and 90s, man, zombie films, all kind of crazy action movies. So I guess she did see it coming.